Reiboot can repair iOS system problems and restore your iPhones easily. Links will be in the description down below. Hey, what is up guys? iDevice Help here and welcome back to the channel. Today, Apple has released iOS 13.3 Developer Beta 2 and it looks like Apple is moving along quite quickly with releasing new betas for iOS 13.3, which could indicate that Apple is looking to release this software to the public as soon as possible. There's some new features coming with iOS 13.3. And there's also improvements, which I'm going to go over here in this video. Of course, you can always anticipate my follow-ups in the next 24 to 48 hours where I talk about the battery, the performance, any bugs, any additional new features and changes that I may come across after using the software. And today's beta is coming in with build number 17C5038A. That's going to be the latest build number for iOS 13.3 Beta 2. Now the software came in at approximately 300 megabytes, which is a nice and decent size of a download. I'm going to be digging through the software. There's quite a bit of fixes coming with this one. Number one is the RAM management issue. Initially presented with iOS 13.2, Apple is fixing it with this beta as well. Now, I've also noticed that iOS 13.3 improved the camera experience for iPhone 11, 11 Pro, and 11 Pro Max. So when you switch between cameras on previous versions of iOS, you would get a black screen, a blurred, it would be glitchy. With the latest iOS 13.3, everything seems to be resolved. The cameras are slightly improved in performance, as you see here. No major hiccups, just a minor blur when switching from lens to lens, but that is to be expected. Everything seems to be improved. The RAM management issue also looks to be improved. So when you launch an application, it will no longer have to reload. It looks like Apple has fixed that with this software update. 13.3 also brings a new feature to screen time. So if you have a child where you're monitoring their digital activity, you now have the ability to go to communication limits. And here you can go ahead and adjust who they contact at what times during screen time and downtime as well. So screen time settings have also been improved and additional features have been added with 13.3. This software also brings improvements to the keyboard. So on settings here, if we go to general and keyboards, we now have the ability to remove Memoji and Animoji stickers from the keyboard. So if we head on over to messages here, we click emoji. You see these previews here for the Animojis and Memoji stickers. You can actually go into settings now and remove those directly from the keyboard. So no longer present there. If we go to Memojis and Animoji stickers, they will no longer be there. So you have that new option for the keyboard as well with iOS 13.3. And you know, this software really brings improvements to the overall performance of Bluetooth, Wi-Fi, and cell connection. At least in my experience over the past several days, I've noticed that Wi-Fi is not dropping as much as it was before. It's actually improved quite a bit. LTE has also improved and Bluetooth connectivity. So once Apple releases this software, you'll be very, very happy with the results. At least that's what I've experienced so far, and hopefully you'll experience that as well. If you're running the beta, let me know in the comments down below, have you seen improvements with Wi-Fi and LTE connection as well as Bluetooth? Because I've had great experience so far. Now, in regards to battery with beta 1, it's been average. I'm going to be testing the latest beta, beta 2, and I'll have a follow-up for you guys. Be sure to subscribe if you want more information on the latest updates for iOS 13. And I hope you guys have a great day. I'll see you real soon. Peace.